الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. And good morning, friends and followers of Asafi, and welcome to another installment in our series Revert Reflections, and another installment under the theme What Sets Islam Apart from Other Faiths. We began talking yesterday about the concept of religious relativism, which is something which is very common in other faiths, and it is something which many of us who have converted to Islam have brought with us as baggage once we converted and made it a part of our Islamic faith. And we have a tendency, sometimes inadvertently, to revert back to this concept and to adopt it and to adapt it into our faith and into our practice. And so we wanted to talk about the Islamic perspective on the concept of religious relativism. And we began that discussion yesterday by talking about what religious relativism is. And now we want to basically talk about what Islam says about it. So Islam's stance toward religious relativism is one of diametric opposition. And the indications of this rejection of religious relativism in the Quran and in the Hadith range from explicit, implicit, and a combination of the two. So you'll have in the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will explicitly say that the truth is one and it's absolute. And likewise, you'll have the Prophet saying it very explicitly in the Sunnah. And you also have some text where it is, you have to kind of read between the lines, but it's implied there, it's implicit that the truth is one and absolute. And then you'll have sometimes a religious reference from the Quran or from the Hadith where there is a mixing from Allah or a mixing from the Prophet between explicit and implicit evidence that the truth is one and absolute. And so what we'll begin doing today, inshallah ta'ala, is looking at some of these texts and contemplating them together, inshallah ta'ala. And the first selection that we'll look at today comes from Surah An-Nisa, Surah An-Nisa is the fourth surah, and we're going to be looking at verses 60 through 65, inshallah ta'ala. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these verses, he says, أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ يَزْعُمُونَ أَنَّهُمْ آمَنُوا بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ وَمَا أُنزِلَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ يُرِيدُونَ أَن يَتَحَاكَمُوا إِلَى الطَّاغُوتِ وَقَدْ أُمِرُوا أَن يَكْفُرُوا بِهِ وَيُرِيدُونَ أَن يَتَّخِذُوا بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ سَبِيلًا وَيُرِيدُ الشَّيْطَانُ أَن يُذِلَّهُمْ ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ تَعَالَوْا إِلَى مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ قَالُوا وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ تَعَالَوْا إِلَى مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ وَإِلَى الرَّسُولِ رَأَيْتَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ يَسُدُّونَ عَنكَ سُدُودًا فَكَيْفَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ ثُمَّ جَاءُوكَ يَحْلِفُونَ بِاللَّهِ إِنْ أَرَدْنَا إِلَّا إِحْسَانًا وَتَوْفِيقًا أولئك الذين يعلم الله ما في قلوبهم فأعرض عنهم وعذهم وقل لهم في أنفسهم قولا بليغا. So in this series, in the first part of the verses, which is 60 to 63, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, have you not seen those who claim to believe in what was revealed to you and what was revealed before you? Now this is important and we have to pay attention. This is one of those texts that we talked about where Allah is both implicit and explicit in his rejection of religious relativism. So we have to pay attention. So Allah says, أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ يَزْعُمُونَ. Have you not seen those who claim? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala basically here is indicting them and saying that their belief is a mere claim. It's not true belief. And there's some type of behavior that they're exhibiting that makes their faith not really true, not really valid, but merely a claim. So pay attention to that. Because if Allah is saying their faith is claimed and not true because of a behavior they're exhibiting, it means that exhibiting that behavior makes a person what? Not really a believer. So he goes on and he says, have you not seen those who claim to believe in what was revealed to you and what was revealed before you? Yet they turn to satanic sources for legislation. They turn elsewhere. They turn elsewhere for guidance in religious matters. They turn elsewhere. While they were commanded to reject them. And in the process of turning elsewhere, they disobey a commandment that it had reached them and they had internalized it. But they opted to behave otherwise, to behave in a contradictory manner and to oppose what they were told to do. And Satan simply wishes to lead them far astray. Allah is telling us that if we follow Islam, and in some areas and some aspects and some elements of our faith, we turn to other philosophies, then this will lead us astray. This is something that will lead us astray. The shaitan uses this method to get us to go astray. Allah is saying that basically the straight path is one path. And when you start to borrow from other elements, it will take you away from that path. It will lead you astray. Again, a very implicit and almost explicit rejection of religious relativism. Then he goes on and he says, when it is said to them, come to what Allah has revealed and to the messenger. Come to the truth, the absolute truth. You see the hypocrites, and Allah calls them hypocrites for doing this, that they say out of one side of their mouths, we believe, but then their behavior betrays their statement. Their behavior betrays what they have stated. And Allah calls that hypocritical behavior, or describes it as hypocritical behavior, and calls the people who do that hypocrites. You see the hypocrites shunning you completely. They refuse to follow the one absolute truth and continue to borrow elements from elsewhere and say, hey, there's some truth over here. And the truth is relative. And the way I see it is that this, in this particular issue, at this particular time and space, this is true and should be adopted. And so we can borrow from this. They're saying this. They're taking this approach. So he says, you find them shunning you completely. No, no, no. You don't know. You don't understand. You don't understand. You don't have the level of intellect that I have to understand that, yes, this should be adopted. Then he says, how will it be when a disaster strikes them because of what their hands have wrought, that this is dangerous behavior with potentially dangerous consequences? Allah is telling us again an implicit indication or implicit rejection of religious relativism. Then he says, so how will it be when a disaster strikes them because of what their hands have brought, and they come to you swearing by Allah, we wanted only to do good and to foster reconciliation. We wanted to basically combine the good that we saw in this and the good that's in Islam and put them together and come out with something that's even more good, because it takes the best of both worlds. This is their thought process, and this is how they justify their behavior, which Allah says has disastrous consequences. They are those whom Allah knows full well what is in their hearts. Allah is pointing to the fact that there is a disease in their hearts. Again, another implicit indication or implicit rejection of religious relativism, saying it's that the people who engage in it have a sickness in their hearts. Rather than accepting wholeheartedly the pure truth, the absolute truth, they're choosing to what? To borrow elements from other philosophies and other religious faiths and other belief systems, etc. And he goes on and he says, so turn away from them. Turn away from not just them, but this practice of trying to reconcile between other faiths and believing that truth is not totally absolute, but everybody has a different perspective and everybody is right in their own way. No, Allah says, turn away from that. Turn away from that and believe that truth is absolute and follow the absolute truth from Allah. Turn away from them, admonish them, advise them, and say, hey, what you're doing is dangerous. It could have disastrous consequences. Don't follow that path. And speak to them words that will penetrate their souls. That's verses 60 to 63, brothers and sisters. Then Allah, he goes on to say in the following verse 64, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا لِيُطَاعَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. We have only sent our messengers to be obeyed absolutely by Allah's will. Absolute truth to be followed absolutely, because what they brought is absolute truth. There is no error in it. And whatever truth is outside of that is included in it. Meaning that the other faiths and philosophies may not be totally wrong. Whatever truth they have is included in Islam. But at the same time, the falsehood that is in those philosophies has been debunked by Islam. So we don't need to follow anything else except what has been brought to us by Allah's messengers. We have not sent the messenger except to be obeyed absolutely. Not in some things and disobeyed in other things. And then Allah, he closes this series of ayat with verse number 65 saying, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِي مَا شَجْرَ بَيْنَهُمْ ثم لا يجدوا في أنفسهم حرج مما قضيت ويسلموا تسليما. Nay, by your Lord, they will never be true believers or have real faith until they accept you, O Muhammad, as the judge in all, underscore the word all, disputes among them, and find no resistance within themselves to what you have decided, and submit wholeheartedly. Brothers and sisters, this is both implicit and explicit rejection of the concept of religious relativism, because Allah is saying we will never be believers until we accept the judgment of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in all of our disputes, in all of our discussions that have something to do with religion or are even remotely related to spirituality. He is the judge. He is the deputy of Allah. He is the one who has been guided by Allah to show us the straight path of Allah. And that path, as we're going to see in the coming days, is one path, not many paths. And so you can see from this series of ayat, five verses from the Quran, from Surah Al-Nisa, you can see a combination of implicit and explicit rejection from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from on high, of religious relativism. And it's important for us to reflect upon this. If we say that we are Muslims, and our beliefs are Muslim beliefs, and our practices are Muslim practices, and our stances on the issues are Muslim stances, Islamic stances, then this is what our deen is saying. And are we going to oppose it? Are we going to take an oppositional stance? And if we do that, how can we say, truthfully say, that we're Muslims? It's something for us to reflect on, brothers and sisters, and this is what we're here to do, to reflect. Revert reflections. Let's reflect together upon where our faith is, where our religion stands, and where we stand, and try to make sure that we're standing in the same place. If we're saying that we're Muslims, doing the Muslim thing. More on this, brothers and sisters, in the coming days. Hadha wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak an Nabi Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.